So here's the first round of the league that I'm playing. On the draw, and it's not the best, but it's pretty good. Could use like an Elvish Mystic, but then again, so I could just about every hand, so can't always have it. As for a non-Elvish Mystic hand, it's pretty good. Looks like we're playing against blue-white control, probably, would be my guess. I haven't actually played this matchup yet, but I think that it isn't too bad. It definitely gets a lot better post-board. Game 1 might be a bit rough, but once we get Den Protectors and Thought Seizes, the matchup seems like it should be pretty great. You know, their deck plays a lot of like counter magic or whatever, but it's usually pretty easy to sneak in a Den Protector, because we have, you know, we have a lot of cheap creatures that can create pressure, so he's going to have to tap mana to deal with their stuff, and then Den Protector's only 3 mana to morph, so... I think I want to crack this fetch land before I draw. I'm gonna play Visionary this turn, so next turn I can play Dwynan's Elite. This Wayfinder, unfortunately, is not an elf. Elvish Visionary might get Clash of Wills, but I'm not. Wouldn't be too upset about that. Unfortunately, we don't have another elf for this Dwynan's Leap, but I mean, I can play Wayfinder next turn, maybe hit like a Scryland or, you know, something else, and then, you know, there's a lot of elves in the deck we can draw. I could also just maybe cast Absent Charm next turn to draw 2 cards. It's another option. We'll see. Depends on what I draw. If I draw another land, I'm more likely to cast Absent Charm, but since I didn't draw a land, I kind of just want to play Wayfinder, just to increase the chances that I can then play Siege Rhino next turn. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I could play my land first to play her in Clash of Wills, but I think I'd rather have him Clash of Wills this than have it for, say, my Siege Rhino. You know, like, yeah, I might miss my land drop next turn, but then I can Absent Charm, draw 2 cards. I'd also rather him Clash of Wills than Absent Charm too, so I'm not gonna play my land. Another thing, if I hit a tap land, I really wanna play that, so definitely right to play this before I play the Lanar Wastes. I mean, if he doesn't do anything, which, I mean, he's very likely just to play land go. I'd be tempted to just Court of Calling end of turn for, like, a Visionary or something, because I don't really want to just run my Rhino into a Dissolve. And then if I get a Visionary, so I draw a card, obviously, then I have... Not a great clock, but 2 turns reasonable, and then I can play Dwynan's Elite, which he basically either has to counterspell or, you know, play a sweeper or something, because even if he just has like a Last Breath or something for my Dwynan's Elite, that's still 3 damage a turn, which is, you know, a reasonable clock. Rally, well, that was a good draw. Obviously it doesn't do anything yet, but it will do something. Now, I think I am just going to jam Siege Rhino, because I want to get his counter spells out of his hand. And, Siege Rhino in my graveyard is not too bad, so. So it's that, or, again, I could Cord for Vision. If I Cord for Visionary and draw a land, the next turn I can play Dwynan's Elite and draw 2 cards off Absent Charm, which is kind of nice. And still just kind of save this Siege Rhino. I kind of hate using Cord just to get a Visionary, but... I could also get a Satyr Wayfinder, I guess. Since I have... rally. Obviously, that would not give me an elf for Dwina's elite, but I think I'm gonna do that because it's also possible that he just counterspells the cord. You know, I don't. I mean, he probably, if he knows the deck at all, he won't counterspell it. And really, there's not that many scary two drops, but people see a card like Cord and, you know, they think, oh, I have to counter that, without considering what it actually might get. So we'll see. If it resolves, I'm probably just going to get a Visionary here. So I really want to be able to play this Dwinin's Elite. Also just makes him waste another three mana, you know, like there's three mana that he just didn't use. Whereas if we cast a spell, it's very likely it's just going to get counterspelled, so. Yeah, I'm definitely just gonna get a Visionary if it resolves. Yeah, like I said, I'm not surprised when people just fire off their counter spells like that. And this is great because now if we draw land, I can cast Siege Rhino and even not get it counter. I'm gonna cast Siege Rhino anyways, but if I draw land, it's almost. I guess I could have Disdainful Stroke. I don't know if they play that in their main deck though. I can't remember. Okay, well, so I'm gonna cast Siege Rhino no matter what. So if he has Disdainful Stroke, he does. But now it can't get counterspelled by a Clash of Wills. So that's nice. Even if he has Disdainful Stroke, he's only got three cards left in hand, and I still do have this, you know, I'm gonna add an Charm to draw two cards, and I have Rally for, you know, right now I have two Visionaries in my graveyard, so it's at least a draw two, even if, you know, it's not gonna kill him or whatever. And if he counterspelled Rhino, it'd be draw two, he loses three, and I gain three, so. So yeah, he's gonna Wrath now, which I guess is. I mean, obviously, there's nothing we can do. I'm trying to think. Well, I mean, you'll see what I draw. Hopefully, I just draw an elf so I can just play elf, Dwinin's Elite. But I'm probably just going to main phase draw two cards if I don't. Okay. Yeah, I'm just going to draw two cards because I'd like to draw. I'd like to make a land drop just because I have this rally in hand. But I would also like to draw. I'd rather play either a Wayfinder or a Visionary than this Dwinin's Elite if I can. So. But it looks like that's not the case. Still just gonna play this Dwinin's Elite. I don't wanna waste my mana. I wanna use my mana as efficiently as possible. And I wanna, you know, get something on board just so I can attack every turn. So this way when there's turns where he passes with counterspell magic up, then I pass back to, you know, play around his counterspells. I can still hit for two and get something out of the turn. Or hopefully he just wastes his whole turn. So he just passed. He didn't play a land either, so I think it's very likely he has Dig here. So I kind of want to use, I kind of want to play spells no matter what, just because that way it forces him to choose between counterspell or dig. So let's see, I have Rhino, Wayfinder, Visionary Mystic in my graveyard. So a rally isn't that great yet. It's like what, draw two, maybe get a land, and then a drain. I think I'm just gonna play. I'm gonna attack, play Shaman of the Pack, and then if he digs, I'm just gonna draw two. I could also just pass, and if he digs, I could Cord for Nissa. I would definitely do that if I had one more land, just because I could then get Nissa and crack this fetch to trigger it. But and I mean I could just Cord for three to get Nissa right now and play a land, but I think I wanna wait until he taps mana. But regardless, I think I'm just gonna play Shaman anyways. I like this play a little better. If I had a seventh land, I would probably make the Nissa play. But as is, I'm just gonna see, cast a Shaman here. So if he digs, I mean it's great because he's at, you know, 14 or whatever. So if he digs, then we can. I mean, I still have all this pressure. So if he has to, so say he digs and then wraths again, you know, so he taps out. Then I can. He might just be dead because I can go rally for 4, which brings back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elves. So he goes to 8. Siege Rhino puts him to 5, and then I have enough creatures that I can cord for 3 to get another shaman. So, yeah, if his plan is dig into wrath, he's still dead. I'm gonna let that resolve and then draw 2 cards. I could also wait to draw 2 cards, actually, because I'd rather him use mana to counterspell it. So I can resolve this rally. So I'm actually going to wait. I guess he could have like a clash for 1, and then he could have like 2 counterspells and be able to cast them both. No, because then I can just... Because if he has 1 counterspell, he probably just lets it resolve. But the thing is, if he only has 1 counterspell and he counterspells it, is the benefit I get. If he has 2 counterspells, it's better for me to do it now. I guess if he has a counterspell and a removal spell, because like I said, I'm gonna untap an attack, so he'll have to use, you know, like a last breath or a swift reckoning. But actually, if I cast this now, he can't even swift reckoning because he doesn't have. Because the only way he'd be able to swift reckoning is if I do this end of turn, he counters it and then has swift reckoning for my shaman at least. I think I'm just gonna do it now. A little better, I think. I'm gonna fetch this too. Two. Another rally, that's good. So now, even if he doesn't tap out, now I can just, you know, attack for 5, pass, then on his end step, rally again. So if he counterspells that, then I can attack for another 5. So he basically has to use removal at that point because he's going to go to 4, and then I can rally again. But yeah, like I said originally, it's very likely he was just going to... I was thinking dig into Wrath, but dig into Elspeth. That's definitely worse for us since now my shaman's not dead, but I can just murderous cut it, I think. I think I have extra mana to do that. So let's see. How many creatures do I have in my graveyard? Because if I don't bring Dwight, well, first I can attack, because he might just, you know, double block my shaman or something. 1 for 4. So I can cut my shaman and then bring back 1, 2, 3. So 3 elves plus 4 in play, so 5, including the shaman. So I'll have 5 elves at minimum. So he goes to 9. Siege Rhino drains him for 3, goes to 6. Then I cord for another shaman, which is 6 elves. Okay, so yeah. And I can cord, right? I'll have 1, 2, 3. So maybe I actually can't attack. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 creatures. So yeah, I can't attack. I can attack with a shaman. Oh, I'll have an extra mana, so I could have attacked, but it doesn't matter because he's dead anyways. And he has double blocking, so I don't even need to use Murder's Cut. Oh, no, so I was right, because I had to Murder's Cut, so I wouldn't have had an extra mana, so I couldn't have attacked with the Elite. Now I can, Or now I don't have to cut, so... I could Murder's Cut my Dwinen's Elite, but I don't think it matters. I'm going to, just in case I did the math wrong. So rally for 4. Make sure I stack these right. My moto's lagging a bit. There we go. I just have to make sure you stack the Shaman trigger before you stack the Dwayne and Zilly trigger. None of this really matters. Come for three. And get another Shaman. So it's great winning game one because, like I said, I think games two and three are where the matchup gets really good. Game one might still just be very good for us because, again, we can make a decent clock and then forces him to react to that, and then, you know, we can react like exactly like we did there, and then you force him to tap out and then just rally and kill him. But post board, it's just got to be great with Dem Protectors and Thought Seizes. Get rid of these murderous cuts, although. Murder's Cut, it does kill Jace, but that's the, you know, that's it. Get rid of Reclamation Sage. Most decks don't play Banishing Light, as far as I know, most of the blue-white decks, because they're playing stuff like Ugin. But I don't love Cord in this matchup. Obviously, it was great there, but a lot of if he's Wrathing and stuff, it's going to be hard for me to keep up, you know, to have many creatures. I guess just Cording for, like, three off of just lands isn't too hard. I guess I'll leave them. I mean, I gotta cut something. I'm gonna trim a cord and then maybe cut Sadisi. Sadisi is really expensive. I think the game's gonna go so long that we're gonna, you know, I'm not really gonna need to cord for Sadisi, I don't think. We'll just draw enough rallies if the game goes to turn, you know, 12 or whatever. To trim one more card. I changed some of the numbers around in the sideboard recently, and I haven't really made sure, like, it's possible the numbers are a little off still, because obviously we have too many cards to bring in here, so that could be kind of a problem. I'm just going to trim another cord. I don't think it's great. One is not bad, though. You really don't want to draw two, just because you need to... You need to be doing stuff, and again, it's hard to cast cords, you know, too early in this matchup. Like, you're often going to have to wait till you have, especially because if you're doing it early, then you're not attacking either, which I like to, you know, you want to always be putting pressure on him to force him to do stuff. So, when you're cording, it's often going to be off of six lands, so, you know, if you draw two before turn six, it's just going to clog up your hand. I think I'm going to keep this. It's a little... It's obviously very risky, you know, if I just don't draw second land, but I have a Mystic and then great cards after that. You know, the only Wrath this deck plays costs 5 mana, so I have plenty of time to use this Mystic before he Wraths. And I also have an Elvish Visionary to, if he doesn't have, like, a Last Breath immediately, I can at least draw one extra card. Granted, we just drew a Plane, so... Not the best land we could have drawn, but at least now if he does have a Last Breath, I can still cast my Visionary. And then after Visionary, if I don't draw more lands, I can cast Dwayne and Zilliat, which is still, you know, decent pressure. You know, I guess we got very lucky that we drew out land, because he did have a Last Breath, so... You know, just the luckiest ever. So now this is perfect, so I can play Visionary this turn, the next turn I can play Dwayne and Zilliat, Sandstep Citadel. So it would have been kind of annoying if he played Jace there, but... I should attack first because he might... I don't think he would, but it's possible that he casts Last Breath on Visionary if I just play Dwayne Insulate. But there's obviously no way he just Last Breaths a Visionary Cold, you know, for one damage. I guess I also could have played Forest to play around Clash, but I just want to get the Sand Steps that don't play. So he did actually end up Last Breathing my guy, so good thing I attacked. Obviously one damage isn't, like, super important, but, you know, it could be the difference between winning and losing in the end. You never know. So I could cast Thoughtseize, Dwayne and Zilliat, or I kind of want to use my mana a little more efficiently and cast Dwayne and Zilliat's Seder Wayfinder. If he has a Wrath, it's not great. But then he has to tap out, and I can rally to get back a satyr and two Dwinens elite, which isn't very good. It's, you know, all it is get a land, make two 1/1s. So Thoughtseize is definitely better against Wrath. I guess I can just next turn just double Wayfinder. So I think I'm just gonna Thoughtseize here. Oh wow, his hand is very bad. Can't see the last card. Dig, yeah. So he has nothing but lands. Play this, get some more pressure on. Think we're very likely to win this one, unless you just drew a Wrath. That would be bad, which it looks like. Okay, well, the game's close now. I still think we're definitely favored, considering he has all lands in hand, and you know, I've got this rally with double Satyr Wayfinder. I'm gonna play this first because I like a Dwinens elite. I don't want to play that. Thoughtseize, I certainly don't want to cast that. Hopefully hit a scry land. Nice. I got a shaman, so little bit of power to the rally. It's not the best rally ever yet, but we're working on it. So I can drain him for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, and make 2 1/1s. So that's actually pretty good. Ooh, that was a great draw. So now I think I still know his hand, right? Because he. Sorry, I'm just scrolling back here looking for my Thoughtseize. Okay, it was. Yeah, I was gonna say, he didn't have that in hand. So his hand is still Island, Haven, and Spirit Dragon. So I'm not gonna Thoughtseize him. Gonna jam this Rhino and attack for two. I could have played Satyr Wayfinder there and hit an untapped land, but that's just super greedy. I just want to jam Rhino. I mean, this way, there's so much pressure. If he takes one more hit, suddenly my rally is just lethal if he Wraths and kills this Rhino. It's almost lethal anyways because I can deal six with the Shaman. I could Thoughtseize him now, which is good if he has Swift Reckoning. Also, if I Thoughtseize him before end of turn, it's good if he has Dig, because then I can take whatever he digs before he gets a chance to play it. So I think I'm going to cast Thoughtseize. And I guess if I'm going to do it, I might as well do it pre-combat. Something. Odratize command, okay. Also good to do this now because again I can take whatever he draws. Okay. I guess there is some merit to saving it just because next turn I can Thoughtseize him and then rally for three, so just so I can make sure the coast is clear. Yeah, so even hit another Dwinen's Leap, so this the Shaman in my graveyard is gonna deal lots of damage. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, and he just threw that, so he's just dead. Even to record just in case. Attack him and then rally for millions. Three. This shaman just actually deals. What is it? Eight. One, two, three, four, five, six. I guess that's not as much as it seems because we have three creatures that aren't elves in play. So, it was round one. I think that matchup's pretty good. So, I'll be back for round two in a minute.